So, welcome students. Basically, till last lecture, what we have seen was the basics of regular expression and finite automata. Basically, regular expression and scanners possible, the tokens that we can make out of a statement, you know. So these were the regular expressions we have seen. These are the possible regular expressions and their meaning. Then we started understanding that how we can recognize these regular expressions, right? This can be recognized with the help of finite automata. So these can be manual or automatic. That is a different thing. First of all, you would have studied this finite state automaton. Still, we have to revise it. Where you would have studied that this finite state automaton is a factorial system, where we have alphabet, we have states, final state, transition rules, and these things. So basically, what is important is in your this automaton. You will have a finite set of state. Among these state, one will be your initial state. One or more final state you will have, and at the same time, some of these states will be labeled or numbered. These state will have some label so that you could recognize where your system is currently. So. Then you will have a set of transition rules. Transition rules will let you know that you are in a particular state, and on the particular input, in which is your new state. Then you will have to read the input symbols, and accordingly you will have to decide what should be the transition rules applicable. Epsilon transitions can be taken at any time. Epsilon transitions can be taken. It says that even if there is no input, you can transit from one state to another. This is possible in case of an FA. Now, except when final state is reached and no more input. In your finite automaton, you will have several states. Some of the states are final state. So, as the input comes, you keep on changing your state. And somehow you may reach a final state. Now, if you are in a final state and there is no more input, it means that your string that you have given as input, it has been accepted. Okay. Now, if you are not in a final state, then you will reject this string. Now, let us say we have an example cat, C-A-T. For this, we are making a simple automaton where this is a starting state, initial state. So from here, if we get a character C, we change our state from here to a new state. If we get a here, not here, if we get in this state, this state means we already have a character C. In this state, we are getting input A. Then we will transit from this state to a new state, which means that till now we have two input characters C, A, and we are progressing towards the final state. So at this state, if we are having T, in that case, we will reach the final state. If we are not reaching T, in that case, we may halt our system. Then, now this finite acceptors that we have seen, finite automata, it can be of two different types. So it can be NFA or DFA. DFA is deterministic in nature, where we don't have any choice. At each state, we define all the possibilities that if our alphabet says there are four alphabet symbols. In that case, we assume that there are four possibilities, and on each state we will have to define all the possibilities, right? That if a symbol A is coming, what we will do, in which state we are going. However, in case of NFA, we have choices. Okay, this choice thing I didn't tell you about determinist thing. In deterministic, we don't have choice. It means at one state, given one symbol, the transition can be from this state to only one new state. However, in NFA, choices are possible. Given the input, we can transit from state A to B also, and A to C also. So, choice is possible in a non-deterministic automaton. However, it is not possible in deterministic. The other thing was, we will have a proper configuration for all the possible inputs in deterministic. However, it is not necessary in NFA. We will define only for the necessary important transitions, and other transitions we will leave out. So here, except if some way we have reached the final state on the given input. However, we can reject if no possible way to reach the final state. Now, how can we use these final automatons in scanners? NFA and DFA, both possibilities are there. However, if we use the DFA, it will give us a speed. Means we don't have choice. So everything is pre-configured and straightforward. If this is the proper input, we have to go in this particular direction only. So in a way, in the last of this string, we will get to know whether we are in final state or not. However, in case of NFA, there are choices. We may go in this direction also or that direction also. So in case of NFA, what will happen? We will go in a particular direction. If we are reaching a final state, is okay. If we are not reaching a final state, we cannot say that we will reach final state or not. We will come back and go in another direction, and then we will try to reach the final state. If we are reaching the final state, it is okay. And otherwise, in last, we can say, we will be able to say that, okay, we have traversed all the paths, and now we are saying that no possibility to reach the final state. So in case of DFA, it is straightforward and a little fast. However, always we can convert our NFA to DFA. One other thing is, conversion of regular expression to NFA is easy, straightforward. That is a thing because of which we create a NFA for regular expression, and later on we can convert this NFA to a DFA. So in NFA, what will happen, if this is your regular expression, you put a regular expression, you create for this, just this means it accepts A. So you are mentioning only A. If at all it was having other symbols as well, B, C, D, you need not mention those symbols. You need not configure your NFA for them. So you have taken A, and you reach your final state, and that's it. Other thing is epsilon, if at all epsilon moves or not, right? Now in NFA, let us assume you have a regular expression R, S. In that case, you will keep R, and from R, with a epsilon move, you will reach the initial state of S, and the final state of S will be considered as the final state of RS. Now there is something called R or S. So from a state, you will reach with epsilon move to the initial state of R as well as the initial state of S. Then if you reach your final state of any of them, then you reach the final state with in epsilon move. R star clean closure. So with a epsilon move, you will reach the R any number of time as much as you want. However, you will come back to this state from the final state only. So there is a well-formed way of converting NFA to DFA. Very straightforward. You would have studied this in your other lectures. However, what we do is we create a subset. Subset all the possible subsets, right? Construct a DFA from the NFA, where each DFA state represents a set of NFA states. Key idea is what? The state of the DFA after reading some input is the set of all states the NFA could have reached after reading the same input. So the algorithm is an example of a fixed point computation. If NFA has n states, DFA has at most 2 to the power n states. This is the number of possible subsets that it can have, right? So DFA is finite, can construct in finite number of states. Resulting DFA may have more states than needed. Yeah, it is also true. Now, let us consider a small example where we want to create a DFA for a handwritten scanner. So, what we do is show a handwritten DFA for some typical programming language constructs, then use to construct handwritten scanners. So, what is setting? A scanner is called whenever a person needs a new token. Okay. So, this scanner stores current position in input. Starting there, use a DFA to recognize the longest possible input sequence that makes up a token and return that token. Okay. So, let us assume we start from here until a white space. We iterate here only. We keep on get character, get character, get character, and if at all it is white space, we will remain here. After that, if it is end of the input, okay, so we will accept end of file. Accept means we will say that yeah, we have reached end of file. If we get something like this, left parenthesis, right parenthesis, semicolon, we can recognize these things, okay. Then if at all we are getting not, we can recognize it, and then we may have equal to or any other symbol. If at all it is equal to, we will accept it as not equal to. If it is another symbol, then we will assume that this was not symbol, right? Similarly, less than equal to, we will consider as less than equal to, or we will consider as less, right? These all are possibilities. If it is 0 to 9, any symbol comes, we will come to a state, and in this state we will keep on iterating for new symbols. If at all it is between 0 to 9, we will keep on iterating, and when a new symbol comes out of the range from 0 to 9, we will go to a state and we will say that till now what we have received was an integer and accept it, right? Other is A to Z. So till when we are getting A to Z or 0 to 9 symbol, we are accepting it, and when other symbol comes, we come out and say that we have identified a new identifier or keyword. So what can be the strategy? It can be handwritten scanner or a machine generated scanner, right? So in handwritten scanner, look up identifier like things in table of keywords to classify. Okay. You can make a good kind of hashing kind of things also. There can be a machine generated scanner also, which will create appropriate DFA for you to recognize your keywords, whatever keywords we will tell you. Okay. It will usually will have more number of states than your handwritten scanners, since you are writing a automaton. You will try to minimize the number of states. However, the machine generated scanner will keep lots of states. So if you will try to implement something in Java, So you will keep a separate class for token, right? In this structure, you will have different kind of states. Okay, these are the values, and then some way of getting new characters, skipping white spaces, and then your get token method. In this method, you will make a token, assign some value, and return it, right? So let us assume it is token result. Skip the white spaces. If no more input, then you will return end of file. Otherwise, you will try to recognize the symbols. Less than if sorry, it is less parenthesis. You will token dot L parent. You have already defined L parent what it means, right? L parent was 4, right? So you will send it, and you will read the next character and return the result. The next character again, if at all it is, it can be recognized. It was not equal to, less than equal to 0 to 9 or other kind of A to Z symbols, right? And after that you will return the results. So for this kind of things, so you can write it manually, or you can use some kind of tools. It can be JFlex, or it can be Flex with C implementation or Java implementation kind of things. So Lex and Yak, you will search. You have a book also in library, Lex and Yak, which will help you in understanding this thing, which is automatic generation of this DFA kind of things. Okay, so thank you for now. We will meet again for the next lecture. Thank you.